Hello everyone, welcome to LICD Lecture 21H. Today we are going to discuss the design of a sawtooth and rectangular wave generator using op-amp. So let us start. Let us analyze what do you mean by a sawtooth wave. So everyone know what do you mean by a triangular wave. So triangular wave have, it looks like this, and it has on time and off time as same. So we can call it as a 50% duty cycle, where duty cycle is given by T on upon capital T, when capital T is T on plus T on into 100. So a triangular wave has a 50% duty cycle, and a sawtooth wave has a less than 50% duty cycle. So these are the two varieties. So in this part, my T on time is greater than my T off, and here my T on time is less than T off. Now T on and T off times are also called as T rise and T fall, basically. Okay, so that also we can remember. Fine, so that's what we have written over here. The sawtooth wave does not have equal T on and T off times, whereas triangular wave has equal T on and T off times. So these are the two possible sawtooth waveforms which are shown over here. Now, what we need to do is, these sawtooth waveforms are obtained by some modification in the triangular wave generator circuit. Okay, so we have seen a triangular wave generator circuit. Yeah, I guess I have to reduce slightly the amplitude. Yeah, I think it's now fine. Okay, so this is my, this was my triangular and sort, triangular and square waveform generator. How we can convert it into, sawtooth and rectangular waveform generator is something like this. Here, the non-inverting terminal of the second op-amp in the triangular wave generator was connected to ground. Here, we connected to a potentiometer, where one end of the potentiometer will be VCC, other end will be at DE, and the third end is connected to the non-inverting terminal. So, just by doing this modification, we will convert this into a rectangular and a sawtooth waveform generator. So, here, if we do that, my VO1 will be a rectangular waveform. And my output of the op-amp number 2 will be a sawtooth waveform. So that's what our objective is today. So these are some points which I've written, that sawtooth waveform has unequal on time and off time. Modification is done by introducing a R-pod potentiometer in the non-inverting terminal of the op-amp. So depending upon the pod setting over here, let me expand it a little. So depending upon this pod setting, we will be giving a DC voltage to a non-inverting terminal of the op-amp. So it is possible to adjust the voltage by just changing this potentiometer value, and that can be easily changed manually. Okay. So additionally, if we are changing this potentiometer value towards the VCC or towards the VE, it also matters. So in one case, it will give you the sawtooth waveform with T on greater than T off, and in other case, it will give you the sawtooth waveform with T on less than T off. Other case, it will be greater than T off. Okay. So depending upon the pod setting, the certain DC value will be added to the integrator output, and which will alter the duty cycle of the square wave which is available at the output of op-amp number 1. So this won't be a square wave, this will be a rectangular waveform basically. So a less than 50% duty cycle will cause the output of the integrator to be a sawtooth wave. So the output of the integrator will no longer be a triangular wave, will be a sawtooth wave. So whenever the wiper over here, the center point is at center, the wiper is at center, the output of the op-amp 2 of the integrator is a triangular wave. Okay, so whenever a pod position moves towards the VEE point, minus VEE point, my rise time will be greater than the fall time, and my T on time will be greater than the T off time. That's what will happen. And whenever my pod position goes towards VCC, my rise time will be less than fall time. That means my T on time will be lesser than off time. Okay, and these are the two varieties of waveforms which we get. I hope that this is visible. Yeah, so over here we get this type of waveforms where my rise time is less than my fall time. As you can see, my I must have written it something. Yeah, my on time is less than my off time. So here what will happen? Okay, so in this case, I have done some mistake here. My rise time will be greater than my fall time. Basically, it's actually happening reverse. Okay, so yeah, I have to change that fact. In this waveforms, it's actually the output of the the integrator circuit is applied at the inverting terminal. So if it is a positive going ramp, that will be a negative going ramp. So that is what will happen. So it is, and that's absolutely fine. Okay, that's not a problem. So over here, my on time will be lesser than my off time. This is my off time and this is my on time. Let's stick to one. Let us not discuss both rise time and fall time and on and off time. So let us only stick to one. So we will stick to on time less than off time. That is my green color is my sorted waveform. As you can see clearly, it will depend upon the rectangular waveform. So integrator is integrating perfectly. So if it is a constant positive value, it is a negative going ramp. If it is a constant negative value, it is a positive going ramp. Basically, the duty cycle of my my output of my op amp number one is changing. So that's why we are getting this type of a sorted waveform. Here also we can see that clearly the other half, my T on is greater than my T off. So that's what will happen. Actually, this T rise and T fall, the greater than and less than will change in both the cases. So that's okay. Now let us quickly design a circuit which will generate a sawtooth waveform of frequency 2 kilohertz and amplitude 7 volts peak to peak. We have done this earlier for triangular wave. All the steps are same. Everything is same. What is changing? I will tell you now. So F naught is 2K. V out peak to peak is 7 volts. So output peak to peak formula, V out is given by twice R2 upon R3 into VSAT. So we got the V out peak to peak as 7, VSAT as plus 14. We got the value, we'll get the relation between R3 and R2 as 4 times, that is R3 will be 4 times R2. Substitute the value of R2 as 10K, value of R3 will be 40K. So we select the standard value 39K quarter volts. Now the frequency of oscillations for a triangular wave is given by F0 is equal to R3 upon 4 times R1 R2 into R2, R1 RC into R2. F0 is given as 2K, so 2 into 10 is to 3. R3 is 40K, R2 is 10K. So 10K and 40K will cancel out, you will get 4. 4 and 4 will cancel out. So R1 into C1 will be 1 upon 2 into 10 is to 3. So we assume the value of C as 0.01 microfarad. So the value of R1 comes out to be 50 kilohertz. Okay, so we select the standard value of 51. And after our all the design values are over, here is my design circuit. So as you can see, my value of R3 is 40, R2 is 10K, R1 is 50, and C1 is 0.0. Also, for making it a sorted wave, I have positioned it. Now, in LTSpice, it's difficult to get a potentiometer directly. Okay, so what I did is, potentiometer means splitting up. So here, if I write over here 8 kilo ohms and 2 kilo ohms, that means the wiper is shifted towards VCC point. Okay, so that's what will happen. So I will get a sorted waveform if I connect the same circuit in LTSpice. So let me try that. Okay, fine. Let me try this out over here. Now let me make it as 22%. Okay, so I guess this is also not enough. Let me just make it like this. Yeah. So over here, you have the circuit to your left and your right are exactly the same. Let me change the, I think this should be R1 as per the, symbol. Yeah. So over here, let me increase this. I've used a faster op amp, LTC 6244. Here is my R3 value is 40K, R2 is 10K, R1 is 50, C1 is 0.01. And this RA and RB are 8K and 2K respectively. So this is VCC and VEE basically, okay? And my supply voltage is plus or minus 14 volts. Fine. So let us simulate the circuit and let us see whether we are getting the output as desired or not, okay? This way or the other way around. So let me just simulate it. Okay. Yeah, we are getting a rectangular wave. So it's a good news. So basically, it's a this type of waveform. Waveform. So and my output is at this. So here it is, perfectly fine. So do you see this? The waveform is clearly visible. onto your left hand side and right hand side, it's exactly the same. So this is plus VRAM, close to around 3.5. If I place a cursor over here, 3.49. And here it is, you know, minus 3.49 again. So we are getting 7 volts peak to peak output. That's fine, perfectly fine. And here my VO1 is plus 13.98, and here it is minus 14 something. So it's perfectly getting, you're getting perfect results. And also the sawtooth waveform are also perfectly fine. Here only one change, that you know, on time is less than off time. So your rise time is actually greater than fall time. Here I made a mistake of writing it less than, it's actually greater than. So this is my rise time and this is my fall time basically. Okay. So here my outputs are behaving, you know, my output, that is output of both the op-amps are behaving perfectly well, and my circuit, just by introducing, you know, a resistor over here, RA and RB, a potentiometer basically, this is acting as a potentiometer. Now if I, this towards VCC and VE, now if I make this as 2K and RB as 8K, I'll get the other one. Yeah, you can see this. This one I got, the other sorted waveform. Same. So this is how I get it. See this? Perfectly fine. So this is my positive RAM, negative RAM. This is my plus VSAT and minus VSAT. So this way we can check the output of your, you know, sorted waveform. And here we have checked out the values actually. And we can work it out with the frequency also. It's coming out to be quite close. 1.985 kilohertz, which is close to 2 kilohertz. My peak-to-peak value, we have already checked it. It's perfectly matching. And my VO1 peak-to-peak is also fine. So this way, we have completed our design. And we are indeed, this circuit is indeed generating a sawtooth and a rectangular wave as follows, as you can see. So this is done just by, you know, placing a potentiometer in the non-inverting terminal of your second op-amp number 2. And you can vary this value towards VCC and VE, and we will get the desired sorted waveform as you have seen onto your screens. So I think that's it for this lecture. We have completed our objective for today, that is designed a sawtooth and a rectangular wave. Next time we'll see some other application of op-amp. So until then, have a good day and thank you.